gonna stop right there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to elaborate on the Abrahamic covenant. That is a covenant where God promised that Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will receive the land throughout their generations. That is a covenant. Covenant means the word agreement or promise. That is a covenant that God made from Abraham to Isaac and Jacob. And that is word that he fulfilled. If we continue to study our Bible, we will find that that covenant was fulfilled. We also have the Masonic covenant. The Masonic covenant is the covenant where, in the Hebrew Bible, God established that the Masonic covenant, after he saved them from slavery, that is the Israelites, he led them into the promised land, known as Canaan. He played the role of defining the Israelites' kingdom. So we thank God for that covenant. That is a promise where he led the Israelites out of slavery into the promised land, which is an agreement that God had entered into as a covenant between the Israelites. So we thank God for his covenant. We thank God for that. And we're going to go into the covenant made by Jesus Christ. And I'll read a scripture to you. And it says, I will give them one heart, and I will put a new spirit within you, and I will remove the stony heart of flesh, and I will give them a heart of flesh, that they may walk in my statutes and keep my ordinance, and they may do, and thy shall be my people, and I will be their God. Now that's where it gets good. Because that's when God made a covenant that we are the children of God, and he is our God. And by being a descendant of God, all the covenants and all the promises that were made in the Bible, they are covenants for us today. Will you read the second scripture, please?
Genesis 26 and 3.
That reads?
Sermon. In this land, I will be with thee, and will bless thee, for unto thee, and unto the seed, I will give all these curses, and I will perform the actions which I swear unto Abraham, thy father.
That is God reminding us of the covenant that he made with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Again, the word covenant means to have an agreement or a promise. And there are so many different covenants in the Word of God that if I were to just take the time to go to every covenant and every scripture, we would be here all night. But I encourage you to continue to read God's word. And I'm going to give you a few scriptures that you can read on your own. You can read about the blood covenant from Genesis 3 and 9. And we can also read about breaking evil covenants from Corinthians 11, 23 through 25. There are so many scriptures about God's covenant. I'm just going to give you the list so you can read them at your own time. That's Jeremiah 31 through 34, Psalm 74 and 20, Leviticus 26 and 9, Nehemiah 1 and 5, Deuteronomy 8 and 18, Psalms 105, 8 through 11, Psalms 106 and 45, Psalms 111 and 5, and Deuteronomy 7 and 7. Psalms 45 and 10. Now that is just a little piece of God's promises, his agreement with us here on this earth. We thank God for being a God that he keeps his word. Whenever he enters into an agreement with us, we know that God cannot lie nor fail. So as it is written in the word of God, throughout the King James Bible, all the different covenants that were made through God for his people. As we read and we follow our history of the word of God, we see that those covenants were kept. That God kept his word and he performed everything that he said he would do. Now concerning us with a covenant with God, I would consider when we give our lives over to Christ and the pardon of our sins, and we turn our lives over to His will and His way, that we have entered into a personal covenant with God. Now, the difference is, do we fall short sometimes? Yes, we do. But that does not mean that God is not going to keep His word, because He said in His word that He's married to the backslider. But there is a written guide, a compass in the word of God to continue to show us just the direction we should go in every situation. I think God has covered every situation from A through Z in His word. So the word of God also tells us to study to show ourselves approved. So as we study the word of God, we enter into the knowledge of all His covenants. And again, I said the word covenant appears 272 times, and it is in 31 books of the Bible. So can you imagine just how many promises that God made unto man concerning the kingdom of God? So we're grateful that God kept His word by His spirit through His light to assure us that He is God, and He is God all by Himself, and that there's nothing too hard and nothing too easy for Him. That He is a promise keeper. He's a way maker. He's a miracle worker. He's that light in the darkness. And as we study God's covenants, it gives us a closer relationship with Him, because we realize everything that it is God has offered through His covenants, which is an agreement unto man. And I want to say a promise, because when you enter into an agreement, and even in this world today, they shake hands on something. And that means, well, we agree. That means, okay, we're okay with that. And if you go into the court of law and they make you raise your hand, put your hand on the Bible and raise your hand, and you have to promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Don't ask me how I know that. But we thank God that that is a covenant, because it's a promise. It's an agreement that you're going to do what it is from the depths of your heart. It's in truth that you will not withhold anything, that you will put it out there and allow it to be manifested through whatever it is that is going to determine that situation. But one thing that we know about God and His covenant is that we didn't have to wait to see what was going to happen, because just as sure as He said it, He did it. There was no time to have to ponder upon whether or not this was going to happen, because just the way He spake it in His word and in His timing and in through His will and in His way, we entered into His covenant. We've received them,